Welcome everyone in our virtual classroom. So in this class I will discuss domestic or house electrical wiring system, and I will also try to explain LT switchgear or low tension switchgear. This is the third lecture of workshop and manufacturing practices. So please let's follow the lecture. I'm starting with LT switchgear. LT means low tension switchgear. The function of switchgear is to control, protecting and switching the electrical circuits. And this switchgear is classified as low tension, high tension and medium tension switchgear based on the operating voltage. And if the voltage is very low, say the voltage is nearly about the domestic voltage 220 or more than that, slightly more than that, in the order of 1000 voltage to 1500 voltage, then the switchgear that is used called low tension switchgear or LT switchgear. The different electrical components that are used for these LT switchgears are the various types of fuse, the isolator, MCB and various switches. Now we will discuss in details about these component of switchgears. First, it is the KitKat fuse. It is a very common fuse that is used almost everywhere in especially in domestic wiring to separately a metal conductor or fuse wire is used between these two, and the function is when the temperature increases due to heavy load, means due above the rated load. Rated means, say in our connection the maximum current in normal condition should flow 10 ampere. And we will choose the fuse wire based on this 10 ampere current. Now if for a certain instant due to heavy load the current is 15 ampere, then due to this overflow it will heat and melt. And after melting the connection between these and these will be detached. So this is what is KitKat fuse. It is a very from the very beginning this type of fuses are used. Now apart from these KitKat fuse, more fuses are there. That's our glass Curtis fuse. Here the conducting wire or fuse wire is not open, rather it is concealed within a glass cylindrical shape container. And when these fuse wire cuts due to overload, then there is no scope to replace this wire. This is the wire, rather the entire Curtis need to replace. And this Curtis should be placed here. Another most important component of switchgear is iron clad insulator. The body of this isolator is made by iron or cast iron, and that's why it is called iron clad. and the isolator. Isolator, it is actually the part, it is called the main switch. When from the supply, your domestic connection is connected via this main switch. The switch is operated manually. A lever is there. When is the lever is in upper direction, then it is engaged. And when you will down this lever, it will disengage. And here two different fuse, KitKat fuses are used to control the overflow of the current. The fuse rating depends on the total load of the house. Means you have to calculate the total load, and based on the total load, you will decide, say your total load is 1 kilowatt in maximum, when the maximum power consumption is going on. Means you have to add all the appliances power and then sum up it. Say it is 1 kilowatt. And you know your voltage is 220 in domestic purpose. So you are getting applying the formula P equals to VI, you are getting the current in the order of 4 ampere or nearly about it. So you should decide this fuse, KitKat fuse, as a 4 ampere rating. Nowadays, MCB or miniature circuit breaker is most important part of the low tension switchgear in domestic or any industrial application, or almost in all electrical applications. It simply breaks the circuit like a fuse. What is the function of fuse? While overflow of current, the conducting wire melts and detached the connection, breaks this connection. So fuse also acts as the breaking of the connection while overflow. And a similar phenomenon for the same purpose, this MCB is used. It is also disconnected when overflow of current is there. But the facility of this MCB is that this disengagement of current, means breaking of circuit, is not permanent, unlike fuse. Here this disconnection is temporary. After disconnection, after breaking the circuit, just hold this lever, and it is upward is the on position and downward is the off position. So automatically then we automatically, if there is an overflow, then it will trip. We'll use the word trip. Trip means this lever will automatically move down, means breaking of the circuit. Then manually you can again uplift this lever and it correct it, connect the circuit. And if still there is a problem in the circuit, overflow is this problem is still there, then it will this setup will not be permanent, rather again it will fall. So if it trips, it is advised that check your line whether any fault is there or not, make it repair, and then again connect it. So no components here will damage. So that is the facility of the circuit breaker over the switches, fuses. And the different types of MCBs are there: single pole, multiple, double pole, and triple pole. If only one phase is connected, then it is single pole. If the two phase is controlled, then it is double pole. If two pole means neutral and live. In case of domestic wire, we know it is the single phase connection. सिंगल फेज मींस वन इज द फेजर, अदर इज न्यूट्रल. इफ ओनली द फेजर इज कनेक्टेड टू द स्विच MCB, then it is a single pole. Phase and neutral, both is controlled by the MCB, then it is the double pole. And in case of three phase connection, then it is the triple pole. So these are the single, double and triple pole MCB. How a MCB works? Actually, it's to some extent a mechanical arrangement. Rather, it is better to mention that electromechanical. This type of lever is there, which is the moving component. And when there will be overflow of the current, then due to that, this magnetic magnetization will be there, this type of coil is there, and due to this magnetic induction, the attachment and disengagement and engagement is controlled. And for that, very important part is this bimetallic thermal overload, these bimetallic things. This bimetallic conductor bends depending on the voltage applied. So based on that, it is controlled. If high load, it moves significantly and detaches the connection. And again, after the maintenance of the line, you can engage it again. So this is the working principle of an MCB. We know the function of the switch, means simply it is on off the appliances, and how we'll decide the switch based on the power consumption in the appliance and the voltage. In all domestic purpose, our voltage is 220. Now the power consumption depends appliances to appliances. Say it's a bulb. In that case, the power consumption is 20 watt. Now what is the current? Power divided by voltage. Say this current is 1 by 11 ampere. Now you will choose the switch more than that, so that within that current it will not damage. Now that is very known. Now I am discussing here two-way switch. There is a special connection so that the lamp on the bed can be controlled from both the switch, this switch as well as this switch. This on off can be controlled by both this one. How? Here I have shown this connection. There are three wires, and at a time the switch either will be connected to this or this, and corresponding to every of this connection there is a combination. What is the combination? They follow this. If this terminal is L2 and this is called L1, and similarly this is L2 and this is L1, and if both the switch attached to L1 or L2, then only circuit completes. Say both is connected to L1, okay, then a current is coming through this L1, but here it is disconnected because this is also connected to L1. Then no current will pass through this path. Okay. Then as it is connected to L1, so this path is complete. And again, this is L1, it is connected to that one. Okay. Then the current is going on to this path. and go to neutral. So it is lightning. Again say both is connected to L2. Okay, so through this path current is coming. Now L2 is connected, so L2, this path is complete. But here this is the path for L2, the current is going on, circuit completes. But if the combination is L1 and L2, then there is no current. Say it is connected to L1, okay. So this is the L1 path, and this is the L2 path, okay. This is the L2 path. Then this connection, this current is not flowing through the bulb. Similarly, if it is here it is L2 and here it is L1, then also the circuit is not complete. So this is the way to prepare the circuit for two-way switches. And definitely wire is very important for any electrical connections, even all connections. So different types of wire, how will decide based on the current passes through that. Generally, whatever wire will decide for the main line, the same wire need not be used for a particular room, for a particular appliance. Why I am saying you that the main line that carries the total current of the room. If the total power consumption of a room is maximum 5 kilowatt. So you have to decide the wire diameter based on that 5 kilowatt. So definitely it is a high diameter. But in case of particular appliances, say it is the wire from the switch to your bulb, which is only 20 watt. Unnecessarily, you need not use that high thickness wire for this, because in that case, your costing will be high. So without reason, you will not expense a mass. And apart from this, so many parameters are there to choose the cable or wire. That is the quality of the insulator, which is very important in case of domestic appliances due to the safety reason. And particularly what types of conductor, say whether it is the conductor is made by copper or aluminium or something else. If it is the copper wire, then definitely it is a very good conductor, but cost is high as compared to the aluminium. Though nowadays in household wiring, in most of the cases the copper wires are used. And in case of some lighting, some aluminium wires may be used. So this is the wire, and the or there is some different color of the insulator are there. Generally the red color, the copper wire, definitely the wire has same color, but the insulator, various colors are given to identify various phases. Generally in case of domestic wire, it is a single phase connection, one live and another is neutral. Then live wire is by red color and the neutral is by black color. We will discuss here a typical wiring of a house like this, and that consists a number of switches, the two-way switch or bell switch or bed switch, the calling bell, the lamp point, the fan point, the distribution box. So all these application. based on the connection, we'll postulate this type, we'll fabricate this type of wiring system that includes most of the common appliances that we are using. Now, let's see what components are there. Now, using LT switching elements and other appliances, we have constructed or connected a typical house wiring, and these are the elements of or component of the wiring. First, the kilowatt hour meter. We know that in all domestic purpose, a meter is there to measure the consumption of power. And then this is the isolator, as I have told you, for main switching purpose. And the calling bell is one of the appliances, the fan point. Other components are the DB box. Within the DB box, there are DP MCB, means a double pole MCB, and the single pole. These two are the single pole MCB, and this is the double pole MCB. And some light point, the main switchboard. Now, I will discuss how to construct or make the line. In the fabrication of house wiring, we first have to decide about the wires. As I have told you, it is the single phase connection. So, from your supply, the two wire is coming. One is for the live wire, another is for neutral. Means this is the phase wire. Now, what is the dimension, means magnitude of this wire, that depends on the load. Load means what is the total load of the house, that is equals to summation of all the wattage of the appliances. Then that is the total power, and you know the voltage, calculate the current, and from the current we can determine the corresponding wire. Okay, after selecting that, these will come to the meter box where the power consumption reading will carry. Now, from there, the connection come to our fuse. This is a KitKat fuse. The live wire only pass through this KitKat fuse, and then it is connected to the isolator, ironclad isolator, that isolates the line. Now it comes to the distribution box, this tool through wire, neutral and live. In the distribution box, there are a neutral link. This neutral, a number of port is there for any connection. Neutral can be directly joined to with this, and this is the double pole MCB for neutral and for live. For both are this MCB is working, and that's why it is the double pole MCB. Now one live wire from the air goes through a single pole MCB. And in our, as per our design, there we have considered two different single pole MCB. This is for one, this is for another. Now, the one line, the live line only goes to there, and there is a two-way switch. And I have explained you what is two-way switch and how it is operating. Then, these two-way switch operates the lamp. Or it is also known as the bed lamp. bed and the corresponding switch is the bed switch, then it will be connected to the neutral. Then this particular circuit for the lamp is complete. Then the other branch of this lever come to another switch. It is the switch of the calling bell. It is called the bell push switch. Until you will push this button, the bell will on. So this type of switch is this bell push switch. Then this circuit also connected with the neutral through this link to make the circuit complete. Okay. Then another line from the single pole MCB comes to there. Actually, generally it is the main switchboard where this double pole MCB is there, and from there, if there is a individual room, for individual room one MCB may be there. For each of the MCB there will be one connection, each of the room there will be one connection, right. Now these switch come to the main switchboard. Maybe one of these switches is also within this main switchboard. Now it is passed through another KitKat fuse and then two switch. Say there is three different appliances are there, and that's why three different port. Now all of these are switch. This is switch 1, switch 2, switch 3. Now from these switches, other appliances will work. Say through this switch, the next connection is for a fan. Then it will be completed through this neutral link. This is the fan, and the next one is another connection, the switch for fluorescent lamp. Then this circuit completes the through this neutral link. And you know, in your switchboard there is a 3-pin plug to take power in any charger or extension. For that purpose we keep blank plug point here. So all together this is the part of the main switchboard. Now for this switch also it needs a link. For this one, the neutral link. Now the circuit is almost clear. Then the next important thing is that the earthing. In house wiring, earthing is very important. So why earthing is important? Earthing is required as due to unwanted situation. If the body of the appliances are metallic and there is a chance to come in contact with the body, with the human beings, and if there is any short circuit, means loose connection, due to loose connection or damage of the connection, damage of the wire, the body is in contact with the circuit, then the body is getting the current. That is known as the body current. Now due to this body current, there may be a accident when a human being touch this body. So we need to have the precaution. What is the precaution? Precaution is make a line with the body to the earth, so that the current, if there is any current on the body, it will pass through the conductor and goes to the earth, and it will not pass through the human body. In that case, the human body and the earth connection, it's a parallel circuit. Now if it is a human body, then also this body current will pass through the human body and goes to the earth. On the other hand, if there is a separate earthing connection, so through the conductor, it will pass through earth. Say this, you touch here and there is the earthing. Now, whatever current, say we know that this iron clad isolator, this body is made by iron, so it is conducting. Now, if there is any disturbances, so that this lever or anything due to loose connection, it is in contact with this body. Now, what is body current now? Now, due to this body current, if you pass here, then current is getting path through your body. On the other hand, if there is earthing connection, then this body current is getting the path through this conductor to the earth. So, the body current tends to go to earth. For that, it is getting two different way, parallel way. One is through this conductor wire, other is through your body. And definitely, the resistance of your body is much higher than this copper wire. So, maximum current will flow through this copper wire, not through your body. And if there is no earthing, then this body current is only getting one path through your body and current is passing through your body. So, that is the accident. And when this body, this earthing connection is there, then even you are touching this body, you will feel no shock. So, due to the system security, we need to have this earthing connection. Now, for what appliances we will apply this earthing connection? The appliances or any device instrument for which there is a chance that the body is metallic and there is a chance to come in contact the metallic body and the circuit. Say here, more examples are this box, this DV box. It is also made by metal, so it should be earthing connection there, should be there. And this plug point, why this plug point? Say a laptop charger is connected through that. Now, if it is not connected, then the charger, at the end of charger, if you touch, you may feel shock. So, these all about this fabrication of house wiring. Now, let's see the video of this house wiring based on this diagram, what we have made, the typical example. So, this is the typical house wiring, where this is the iron clad insulator, this is the DV box, and the rest of the appliances, and here it is the main switch board, and another switch board is there. And some points is shown here, the fan point, the light points are there. This is the references that I have used to prepare this video lecture. Okay, this is all about our electrical shop where we have demonstrated and explained the joining process of the wires or cables to make the household wiring. Thank you for your patience and listening the lectures. And I will expect that if you have any doubt, any queries, please make comments or ask me the question. Your question is always welcome to me. Thank you. And please follow the subsequent lectures also. And the next lecture, means the fourth lecture, is on plastic molding process.
or injection molding process. So I'll expect that you will also follow the that lecture similarly. Thank you.